Welcome back, my fellow assassins, to another WWE 2K17 Nervous Mode episode. We are here in San Fran, California, and we're just a few days away from WWE Battleground. But tonight we're starting things off with the SmackDown General Manager. Let's see what Stone Cold Steve Austin has to say. Well, there you go. Stone Cold Steve Austin laying down the law here tonight. Seems the Wyatt family will face Edge and Randy Orton at Battleground with a partner of their choosing. Dolph Ziggler will get a match on the pre-show. But our main event of tonight is a six-man tag team match. Look at this. Six-man tag team match. The Wyatt family will face Daniel Bryan, Seth Rollins, and Finn Balor. Those three men on the right side have big matches coming up on at WWE Battleground, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. But right now, we're starting things off with the Celtic Warrior. So as we get started here on the final SmackDown before WWE Battleground, we go on to a one-on-one matchup between Sheamus and Dean Ambrose. And Sheamus, ever since Money in the Bank, ever since losing that European Championship, has been on a downward spiral ever since. He lost his championship rematch the week after losing it at Money in the Bank to Cesaro, and then would go on to be defeated by Tyler Breeze last week. And he's trying to get back in the good books. Trying to get a W in his books here. Trying to get a win. But today he's a challenge as Dean Ambrose, one of the hottest talents we have here on SmackDown, on the rise. So Sheamus will have to pull out something from his bag of tricks to get a win here tonight. Maybe some of that Celtic magic from when he defeated Dolph Ziggler at Backlash. But nevertheless, there's Sheamus inside the ring trying to get himself ready for the Lunatic Fringe, and here he comes. The absolute madman known as Dean Ambrose. What a match he has this Sunday, as Dean Ambrose will go one-on-one with Seth Rollins in a steel cage match to finally settle this rivalry ever since starting at pretty much Elimination Chamber. But it was when Seth Rollins came back at Backlash that all this started between him and Dean Ambrose. So that's going to be all come to fruition, come Battleground in that steel cage match. But Dean Ambrose has to focus here tonight because he has a big task in defeating Sheamus right here, right now. Let's see how he does. How both guys do in this matchup. Sheamus, obviously, like before I said that he really needed a win. I mean, he's the former European champion. We know he can get it done inside of that ring. In just these past few weeks, I don't know if it's his mindset. I don't know if it's emotional, mental, physical. Maybe there's a lingering injury. I'm not sure. But Sheamus finally has to, has to find something. He has to find that itch that he has to scratch, because he's at the bottom of the barrel right now in terms of, title picture. Either be European Championship, WWE title picture, doesn't matter. He's just in no picture whatsoever. He's the bottom of the barrel in singles competition. And he doesn't want to be there. We know he can be better. Like I said, former European champion. And, I mean, he has a chance here tonight. Dean Ambrose could be looking forward to his match this Sunday at Battleground. And he could be off his game. But, I mean, that's a far-fetched idea. But it could happen as Dean Ambrose and Sheamus now get back inside the ring. Dean Ambrose with a kick right to the sternum in the midsection. Just continuing this attack. And he tries to pick him up. Sheamus pushes him off. Notice Sheamus looking for a power slam. No! Dean Ambrose countering it into a reverse DDT and just stomping on the face. Just the ruthlessness. The new ruthlessness we've seen of Dean Ambrose ever since turning his back on his family, on his brothers. Now Dean Ambrose going to go to the top rope. Sheamus on his feet. And oh, what a missile drop kick by the Lunatic Fringe. As oh, he's been building momentum ever since losing. Ever since turning his back on the Shield. He won at WrestleMania. And then won at Payback. But, I mean, he's been only facing his Shield brethren at those pay-per-view events, so he wants to get past this. The reason why he betrayed his brothers is because he got no love. And he wants that WWE title. I mean, he's in good position to do that if he wins this Sunday. And of course, if Cody Rhodes does not defeat Daniel Bryan in the co-main event at Battleground, we're going to look for a new number one contender. And Dean Ambrose is right up there. Nice again with the reverse DDT. Now Dean going to go to the top rope once again. A little deja vu from just a minute earlier. What's he going to look for here? And it seems Sheamus is getting back to his feet. Dean Ambrose had other plans like this. DDT just plants his head right into the mat. And that could be it right there. Sheamus could have been out. But Dean Ambrose. Now, just... I guess he's just playing around with Sheamus here. Just as a little bit of a tune-up for this Sunday. Of course, facing Seth Rollins, who's going to be in our main event tonight. That big, big-time six-man tag team match against the Wyatt family. But he's got some backup as Daniel Bryan and Finn Balor. Those going to be his tag team partners here tonight. Let's see, Sheamus. Oh, big forearm. Oh, wait a minute. Lunatic Lariat! Lunatic Lariat by Dean Ambrose. And that could spell the end. Sheamus. Could he get up from this? 1, 2. Yes, he can. Dean Ambrose thought he had it right there, but Sheamus showing the endurance and now going to wait for him to get up. Dean Ambrose. Oh, he's got him loaded. And Dirty Deeds just planting his head right into the mat. And that could be it. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it is. Dean Ambrose is your victor here tonight going into WWE Battleground. A big win for the Lunatic Fringe. The Madman going into the steel cage match. And if that's what he's going to do to his opponents in just a regular match, how do you think he's going to be caged like an animal inside of that steel cage match this Sunday? Guess we'll have to see. That match is going to be pretty much unmissable, folks. Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins one more time inside of a steel cage. Now just look at this Dean Ambrose talking to himself. And oh, that's all. There's not much more you can say. The match that's going to happen, Seth Rollins versus Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose just said he's going to tear him apart. And, I mean, can you blame him? Look at this match. One of the big matches to happen at Battleground. Dean Ambrose just loathing Seth Rollins and vice versa. But we're moving on to our next matchup, which is, of course, the European Championship Open Challenge. Here comes the champion, the fighting champion in Cesaro. And for the fourth week in a row, he has defended his championship here on SmackDown. And I think if he wins tonight, I can safely assume that he might be the best European Championship today. I'm just saying. If I remember correctly, you're Sheamus defended the championship three times. Dolph Ziggler had Backlash. Then against Wade Barrett, Bad News Barrett had Payback, and then of course it would be Battleground that he'd be at Money in the Bank that he would lose that championship. So he defended it twice. But Cesaro captured that title. And look at this! Tyson Kidd! So there's your challenger, Cesaro. Tyson Kidd, the ever-talented last graduate of the Hart Family Dungeon, coming down to the ring. And this will be a fantastic matchup. Just two of the best talented workers we have here on SmackDown. Gonna go one-on-one for that European Championship. But nevertheless, Tyson Kidd, the third entrant in this European Open Challenge. It was Dolph Ziggler the first time, then Roman Reigns. In the Roman Reigns match, he was about to win, but then Finn Balor would distract Roman Reigns, and that would lead to Cesaro retaining the championship. And now here tonight, he has one more challenger in Tyson Kidd. And from my information, I don't think Cesaro has a date with anyone at Battleground, so he might have a well-needed day off. This Sunday at Battleground. So that's some interesting info for you. And there it is, the European Championship. The ref holds it high, and that's the gold that both these men are fighting for here tonight. So let's get to it. Both these guys look ready, and the bell has rung. Here we go. For the European Championship, Cesaro looks to defend his championship once again here on SmackDown. But Tyson Kidd, like I said, one of the most talented, one of the best, I guess you could say, best all-around wrestlers we have here on SmackDown. He can fly, he can take it to the ground, he can show even a little bit of strength. But I don't think you can level up to Cesaro here. As now, oh, look at this! Tyson Kidd proving me wrong! He's just hip-tossed, and now DDT to the champ. And you gotta think, every SmackDown has been unmissable thanks to this European Championship Open Challenge. I mean, anybody could be the European Championship once the night is over. Your European Champion when the night is over, but Cesaro has been, half has been talent, and I guess you could say 75% has been talent. But if you look at last week, there was a lot of luck involved with Finn Balor displaying some uncharacteristic tendencies when he came out to distract Roman Reigns. But it seems he's taken aback since Roman Reigns will face Finn Balor for that Money in the Bank briefcase come Battleground. And now look at this! Half Nelson suplex by Cesaro. Let's get to this match. Cesaro now just rubbing the face, dropping the elbow. He looks to make quick work of Tyson Kidd here as he goes after the arm. If you take out the arm of Tyson Kidd, you take care of that sharpshooter. Oh! Very nice tope atomico by Cesaro. Is now going to look for a snap suplex. No, going to go for a vertical suplex. But Tyson Kidd, oh, just attacks the legs. And again, Tyson Kidd came out here with a plan. Probably he's always one to bring a game plan to a big time matchup. As look at this. Oh! Pump handle gut buster. And before, Tyson Kidd used that drop kick to the knee of Cesaro. If you take out the knees, you take out the base of Cesaro, you take about maybe, 95% of his offense. And now look at this. Oh! Look at this Alpamir water slide by Cesaro, just planning Tyson Kidd. And that might be it right there. Two, no. Tyson Kidd kicking out. But again, Cesaro showing off that brute-like strength. Unmatched here in WWE. Oh, nice calf kick there by Tyson Kidd. And Tyson Kidd is not one to lay down here. He'll bring the fight right to you. If you remember a few weeks ago, it was Tyson Kidd versus Sami Zayn. What a match that was. Certainly stole the show on that particular SmackDown. And that's what Tyson Kidd brings to the table in this kind of matchup. Ooh, And now Tyson Kidd looking for an Irish whip, but both guys collide. And Cesaro now going to look to take advantage in the middle of the ring. Now, Tyson Kidd now just maneuvering out of it. Very nice by Tyson. And now a flatliner to Cesaro. And Tyson Kidd, again, just taunting Cesaro. Says, bring it. Is that all you got? And I don't think you want to do that to the Swiss Superman Cesaro. The champ is the champ for a reason. And now Tyson Kidd just wanting Cesaro to get back to his feet. Tyson, what's he going to do here? Oh, nice blockbuster there by Tyson Kidd. And Cesaro's in a little bit of trouble here. It's been pretty much all Tyson Kidd for the last few minutes of this matchup. But, oh, then nice lariat there by Cesaro. Takes down Tyson Kidd. Now Cesaro going to pick up. And there's the European uppercut that we all know and love. And Tyson, kick right to the chin. It seems Tyson Kidd was not knocked out somehow. And again, Tyson Kidd just taunting Cesaro, saying, like, is that all you got? That's your European champion? Just give me the title right now. Is Tyson Kidd just, again, attacking the leg of Cesaro. Oh, and a drop kick right to the small of the back, it looks like. And Tyson to the middle of the ring now. Oh, looking for another. Looks like a pump handle into the gut buster. And Cesaro is just not in his game here tonight. Tyson Kidd might be walking out as your new European champion. No. Springboard. Oh, looking for the elbow. But Cesaro moves out of the way. And a kick right to the dome. As now. Oh. Cesaro just takes out the legs of Tyson Kidd now. And there is your taunting. Cesaro now taunting the crowd. Not to the challenger in Tyson Kidd. And that has to be, I don't think Tyson even saw it. But if he did, that might get under the skin of the ego. Of Tyson Kidd. And now another flatliner by Tyson. And Tyson now just one of the most cocky SOBs we have here in WWE. As now, shoulder barge back and forth here in the late stages of this matchup. As now Cesaro will pick him up with another European uppercut. And there's another of that mid-air uppercut. And there we go. Cesaro's now feeling it. He's feeling it. But Tyson Kidd again. Back and forth here. Could be anyone's match here. As, now kick right to the chin. Oh, knife edge chop. And now, and we go to the outside as this match spills into the ringside area. And you don't want to be out there, especially with the power of Cesaro. Knee right to the midsection. But it seems Cesaro wants to do this a clean way, wants to get a clean victory. And kick right to the side of the head. And now taunting with the crowd. He's saying it's over. And this might be over. As Cesaro now going to look for Tyson Kidd. Maybe look for that neutralizer. He's got him. Cranks the neck. Picks him up. Puts him down. The Gotch-style neutralizer by Cesaro. And you can count to 5. You can count to 10. It's over. And there is still your European champion with the 4th successful retain in consecutive weeks. As Cesaro is still your European champion. And guys, do not miss this Sunday. It's going to be WWE Battleground. Hit that subscribe button and be the first to watch it when it hits your sub boxes very, very soon. We are back here on SmackDown. As you see, the tag team, the new tag team of Jack Swagger and Mark Henry. That's a powerful tag team. But as you see, the title of this episode, Chemistry Test. Here comes Edge And his tag team partner here tonight is going to be Randy Orton. Let's see how they fare in a tag team matchup going into WWE Battleground. We'll see how they fare in this tag team matchup and see how their chemistry works. As you could probably tell, Edge, I don't know how he feels about this match coming up at WWE Battleground. He was training for a tag team championship match with his partner Christian, but now Stone Cold Steve Austin has pulled an audible in now a six-man tag team match between the Wyatt Family and Edge and now Randy Orton, and we don't even know who their third participant is, third member of that team. It seems Randy Orton and Edge, if they get a win here tonight, will have to do some research about who they want as their tag team partner come Battleground. But here comes the Apex Predator, the Viper, Randy Orton, who has been in this rivalry with Bray Wyatt ever since Backlash. And it seems a lot of rivalry is going to end at Backlash, but we don't even know what Bray Wyatt has planned. Bray Wyatt has this, seems like, grand scheme of things. Ever since losing to Undertaker, he wants that match with Undertaker, and he wants to defeat every single WrestleMania opponent that Undertaker has had on the current roster. So, of course, Randy Orton, of course, Edge, and now I don't know who is going to be the partner, but let's see how Randy Orton and Edge fare tonight, and then we'll get to Battleground. Let's see if they even get through the tag team of Jack Swagger and Mark Henry here tonight. Mark Henry, of course, a former two-time WWE champion, the only two-time WWE champion in Universe Mode history. But it seems like Jack Swagger and Edge will start off the matchup. As Jack now, look at this. Oh, plants him with a gut buster. It seems, there's a lot of pent-up frustration I've heard from Jack Swagger and Mark Henry because, they've been put on the back burner. We haven't seen much of them on SmackDown. I think we've seen Jack Swagger on NXT maybe once or twice. I just think they've been in the backstage area just absolutely doing nothing. They want their time to shine here on SmackDown. So, this is a perfect opportunity against a team that's in a big match at Battleground. If they get winning here tonight, they put their name into contention for a future tag team title shot. But if you guys have a name for this tag team, Jack Swagger and Mark Henry, put it in the comments below, please. And I'll look at them later. Thank you very much. But now, let's get back to this match. Here's Jack Swagger now. Just look at this. Just doing some push-ups. Nothing easy about that. Or nothing hard about that, I should say. As Jack now just, I don't know if he was wasting that opportunity that is this tag team match. He's against Edge and Randy Orton. Oh! And just a back body drop just sends Edge right into the mat. But it won't keep Edge down. The former world champion, I think he's 11-time champion. Sounds right. But now Edge gets just some elbows right into the jaw. Good look for a suplex. No! Jack Swagger now gonna go for, oh, look at these knees right into the midsection and one right to the face for good luck. And for right now, Jack Swagger is holding his own against, oh, gets Edge, but Edge with that DDT, that crank DDT. And now he's gonna look for a tag to Randy Orton, but Jack Swagger is in the way. Now he's gonna bring him to the turnbuckle. No, oh, Edge with a big boot. And now, oh, what a suplex. Saito suplex by Edge just plants Jack Swagger on the back of his neck. And here comes the Apex Predator, Randy Orton, as he tags him into the match. And now going for a big time suplex onto Jack Swagger. And that's no easy feat. Jack Swagger is a big boy. And, oh, big man in that ring, close to 280 pounds. Probably 260 if I remember the math. I remember him being announced as 260. But, oh! Jack Swagger using those knees to perfection. There's another one. countered the run-in by Randy Orton just now, planted one more to his cheek. And here comes the two-time WWE champion. Oh! Now Mark Henry, one of the most impressive and strongest men we have here on SmackDown. Oh! And there's a strength right there, putting down the Randy Orton, I was going to say. As now Mark Henry just working him over. But oh, speaking of knees, there's one right there by Randy Orton. And now Mark Henry is down. Now just a knee right to the kidneys. And now, oh. Well, guys, we have to take a quick commercial break. And we'll be right back after this message. And guys, a huge announcement is going to be made next Monday on Raw. Shane McMahon has a big announcement for the upcoming SummerSlam, so do not miss that episode of Monday Night Raw. Coming to you soon, right after Battleground. And guys, we are here back at SmackDown. Is a nice DDT there by Randy Orton. Jack Swagger has been tagged back in this match. Oh, and now look at this, Randy Orton. Clothesline, ducks the line into a power slam. Vintage Randy Orton has now Randy. You came back at the right time, as now Randy is going to go for the apron DDT. And Randy Orton is feeling it here tonight with these fans chanting RKO. And he's feeling it after that apron DDT for sure. Now this Randy Orton now just taunted to the crowd with the Orton pose. Jack Swagger struggling to get back to his feet. And oh, what a clothesline. What a clothesline from Jack Swagger. And now, oh, look at that lariat by Randy Orton returning the favor. And now, oh, kick right to the face, Jack Swagger. Now going to tag in Mark Henry. And here we go again, Randy Orton, Mark Henry. It's now, oh, well, that's, oh, what a backbreaker. Again, with vintage style now, look at this. The Viper is coiled and ready to strike with the RKO! Planning Mark Henry. And that could be it. One, two, three. Yes, it is. And Randy Orton and Edge get a big victory going into Battleground. They definitely needed that win. I mean, how can you say it even more? They needed this win going to the Battleground to see how their chemistry would work. I mean, following the loss last month in that six-man tag team match. I mean, they needed that type of reassurement going into Battleground. And now they're celebrating their win here tonight, as they should. Let's take a look back at that RKO. It was one for the record books. Look at this. Pinpoint perfection. RKO. And you can see, Jack Swagger did not want to do anything there. He knew it was over, and there are your victors. So Randy Orton and Edge are going to meet the Wyatt family. Oh, wait a minute! Wait a minute! Luke Harper and Eric Rowan, there's the Wyatt family. Speak of the devil, and now they're attacking Randy Orton and Edge. Luke Harper, Eric Rowan doing the dirty work here tonight. And they just laid out Edge and Randy Orton. And there is the patriarch. The leader of the Wyatt family is Wyatt. So Randy Orton and Edge have been helped to the back. The Wyatt family just showing their dominance here tonight. Will this be the scene come Battleground? And oh! I guess we're getting ready for our main event. The Wyatt family is in the ring. And here comes Seth Rollins. So here we go. Main event time already upon us. And here comes the architect. Seth Rollins. And he, like I said before, with Dean Ambrose, he's trying to get ready for his big time matchup come Sunday in a steel cage match against said Dean Ambrose. And that would be a hellacious match. Seth Rollins has to be careful when he's, you know, caged, when he's locked inside of that cage with an animal known as Dean Ambrose. But if Seth Rollins, if I know Seth Rollins, then I know the architect. he will come in there with a plan. He will come in there with a game plan, and he'll try, he'll at least try to, you know, do it to perfection. But here we go. Seth Rollins is in the ring, awaiting his tag team partners. And first, it's Finn Balor. And there is Mr. Money in the Bank himself, Finn Balor, who will put that briefcase on the line this Sunday against Roman Reigns, which should be a fantastic matchup against two of the best up-and-coming talents on SmackDown. But tonight he has a big, big revenge. He wants some revenge, is what I was trying to say. Because if you remember, I think it was 2 months ago, it might have been a month ago, that a big Tixan tag team match was happening between the Wyatt family and Finn Balor and two other opponents. And it was that night that the Wyatt family would take away the undefeated streak of Finn Balor on that night in that six-man tag team match. So Finn Balor has his own score to settle here tonight against the Wyatt family. But he has to look forward to Sunday. He has so much to lose, and Roman Reigns has so much to gain. I mean, Roman Reigns has been after that Money in the Bank briefcase alongside Finn Balor. He's been in that Battle Royal at Payback. He's been in the Money in the Bank matchup, and he just feels that he was so, so close, but Finn Balor was just one step ahead. And you look back last week, of course, Roman Reigns almost going into Battleground as your European champion, but Finn Balor was there to crush that dream. So it looks like Roman Reigns will have a score to settle with Finn Balor come Battleground. But here is the WWE champion. There is your WWE champion, Daniel Bryan, coming down to the ring for one final match. One match before the final match, if you get what I'm saying. He has to survive this six-man tag team match, and then at Battleground, he has to face Cody Rhodes one more time in the final battle between the two for that WWE Championship. But again, the Wyatt family, such a dangerous force here in WWE. You can never underestimate the power of the Wyatt family. But here we go. Six-man tag team match happening right here, right now. Luke Harper starting for the Wyatt family. It looks like Seth Rollins starting for the other team. And now Seth Rollins, Luke Harper, collar and elbow tie up, and now just, wrench in the arm. Takes down to one knee Luke Harper. Now Luke gets out of that hold. And of course, I mean, this pretty much all started the Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose feud. It all started with the match at Elimination Chamber last February, when it was the night that, I guess, everything changed for the Shield, when Dean Ambrose turned his back. But it was Bray Wyatt and the Wyatt family that would spew the words to Dean Ambrose, I guess, releasing this sort of demon inside him, the monster inside him. And that would lead to him, turning his back. So it was Bray Wyatt's words that unlocked this type of mentality that Dean Ambrose is in. And I think Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns have a little beef with Bray Wyatt and the Wyatt family. I mean, their match never ended at Elimination Chamber. It was just kind of called off. So I guess that match never really ended. So we got no kind of, closure, no kind of definitive end to that match. And I think everyone wants a type of rematch between the two teams. But I mean, knowing Dean Ambrose and knowing what the Shield are now, I'm pretty sure that's not going to happen for at least a long, long time. And now Seth Rollins takes Luke Harper inside the ring. Gonna look for a pin here. Well, not even a one count. And Dean Ambrose, Bray Wyatt was going to the ring. A little cheap shot there to Seth Rollins. And now, look at that Hurricane Rana from Luke Harper. And Luke Harper, one of those agile big men in the WWE. And here comes another one in Eric Rowan. Very flexible is Eric Rowan. He can hit you with some high angle calf kicks and stuff like that. So Eric Rowan and Luke Harper, look at that. It's just, they're so intimidating. Just both coming at you at the same time. Now, Eric Rowan, what's going to happen here? Eric, going to go for a superplex off the second rope. And oh, the velocity of that. And Seth Rollins is a bit of trouble here. But it seems the pin right in front of the enemy team is not quite smart. I never said Eric Rowan was smart. But now Eric Rowan go for a pump handle slam. No. Nice reversal by Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins need to tag bad. And Seth just cannot get to the corner as Eric Rowan now going to throw him into the corner. He's going to look for a bit of snake eyes and right on the dot. Eric Rowan now just beating his chest like a gorilla. And just the Wyatt family, systematic destruction of Seth Rollins. And this match has just started. But Daniel Bryan gets inside the ring and breaks the pin. It seems the Luke Harper inadvertently hit Bray Wyatt. But I think with a neck breaker. And Bray Wyatt's just inside the ring now. That can't happen. You need to get out. But again, Eric Rowan putting himself in between the corner and Seth Rollins. And that's smart. I guess Eric Rowan has a little bit of smarts. But Eric Rowan now just running around. Never mind. Disregard I said that. But it seems... Oh, Seth Rollins needs this time to tag out. It seems that's exactly what he's going to do. Now Finn Balor going to... Sorry. Daniel Bryan's going to be tagged in. I thought it was going to be Finn Balor. But Daniel Bryan, the WWE champion, against one half of the tag team champions. Now going to... Oh! Gonna drop the elbow. Sorry, I messed up. Again, drop the neck breaker. And it seems Eric Rowan is now in his own type of trouble. Is now, oh, just never mind. Just fuck me right in the mouth. As Daniel Bryan now gets taken out. I mean, tagging back into Luke Harper as Bray Wyatt has yet to be in this match. Oh. Nice knee there by Daniel Bryan going right to Luke Harper now, but Luke Harper reverses. Never mind. And now suplex, no. Shots to the midsection from Luke Harper. And what a throw. Excuse me, I was drinking water. And now Luke Harper going to bring him up for what looks like a sit-down powerbomb. And that is just pure power. And now going to go for a submission hold. Looks like a variation of the crossface. But I think Daniel Bryan grabbed the bottom rope. And this Bray Wyatt just now taunting Daniel Bryan and the other side, the other team. But again, Luke Harper working over the WWE champion as we speak. But and now looking for a big kick. No, Luke Harper got in the way of that. Looking for a tag. No. And now, Daniel Bryan going to go to the second rope with a sunset flip and just takes him down. And it looks like Daniel Bryan's trying to not get any more tags in for the Wyatt family. And now look at this continuous kicks, the vintage kicks, the classic kicks by Daniel Bryan. One to the head, and there you go. Oh, wait a minute. Could he be going for the yes lock? And yes, he can. Yes, he will, but it looks like Luke Harper's foot. Oh, cheap shot by Bray Wyatt, but it looks like Luke Harper's foot was underneath the bottom rope. But a cheap shot by Bray Wyatt. And now, here we go. Finn Balor gets tagged inside. And here we go. Finn Balor, first time in this matchup. Luke Harper, groggy on the outside. Groggy on the apron there. Finn Balor doing the commendable thing, waiting for Luke Harper to get back inside the ring. And here we go. Both men inside. Now Luke Harper making him pay the price with a sidewalk slam. And Finn Balor's already on the mat, but he gets right back up to his feet. Luke Harper now. Oh, wait a minute. What's going to happen here? Picks him up for a lawn dart. And with that will not help Finn Balor's game plan here tonight. As now Bray Wyatt gets tagged inside the ring now. As now Bray Wyatt, no, Luke Harper looking for a double team. Look at this. Oh! Very unique double team by the Wyatt family, Bray Wyatt and Luke Harper. And Finn Balor hasn't even got a lick of offense here. But here we go now. He's got the offense in. Picks up Bray Wyatt. And oh! Finn Balor with that kick right to the side of the head. But Bray Wyatt's right back to his feet. Guys, we have to take another commercial break. We'll be right back right after this. And guys, this Sunday is quite possibly the biggest main event we've ever had here on Universe Road. It'll be Shawn Michaels putting his Intercontinental Championship on the line against John Cena. Do not miss this big matchup on Sunday. And guys, we are back here on SmackDown. What a big boot by Luke Harper. Luke Harper just absolutely decapitating Finn Balor here. And that might be it, but Daniel Bryan makes the save. And oh, Eric Rowan taking care of Seth Rollins. But again, the Wyatt family, one of the most devastating forces in tag team action. Now, Luke Harper is going to wait for Finn Balor to make it back to his feet. Oh, knee to the midsection. And a discus clothesline. And look at that, Finn Balor folded in half. And that has to be it. But Seth Rollins, I mean, if you think about it, that was actually Eric Rowan's fault. Eric Rowan threw Seth Rollins inside the ring. And before the ref could actually, you know, put Seth Rollins on the apron, Luke Harper went for the tag. And that, and then the rest is history. But Luke Harper with a reverse DDT now going to maybe tag in his partner. But no, it seems Luke Harper wants to do this on his own. Now he's going to tag in Eric Rowan. He wanted one more last shot. But here we go. Eric Rowan and Luke Harper again. Kind of that mob mentality to go after the same person. And just so intimidating between these two big men just coming right after you. But here we go again. Eric Rowan might be going for another superplex. This time onto Finn Balor. And oh no, yes, here it is. Here it comes. The superplex! And Eric Rowan has done that twice now. And I think he's done more damage that he's dealing than he's dealing. Excuse me. But I don't think Eric Rowan feels it, to be honest. I think he just wants to deal damage. But look at this. Bray Wyatt. If you look at Bray Wyatt, he's absolutely exhausted. I don't know why. But Finn Balor trying to get some offense in. And oh. Goes out of the arm. Seth Rollins trying to cheer on the crowd. Trying to get them into this match. And Finn Balor going to tag in the WWE Champion. Now the WWE Champion going to go for a pin. Going to go one. No. Eric Rowan kicks out at two. I think it was just one, actually. I didn't even see. But Eric Rowan, oh. Forearm right to the face. Now into the corner. And Seth Rollins. I believe Seth Rollins is actually the one that is exhausted. He just took a beating in the beginning of this matchup. So I get why he's exhausted. But Bray Wyatt, maybe only 3 minutes in this match. He's exhausted. Oh, nice top of Atomico by Daniel Bryan as he's going to try to, you know, keep the pace up. He doesn't want to slow it down. That's Eric Rowan's specialty is now. Oh, look at this. Another. Again, Luke Harper inadvertently grappling Bray Wyatt. And I don't think that's what he wants to do. It's not look at these. Oh, look at these headbutts. My God. And you're talking about Eric Rowan not even feeling pain. I mean, that has to hurt Eric Rowan the same amount it does Daniel Bryan, but Eric Rowan is just fine. Now here comes the Patriarch. Bray Wyatt coming into the ring. As Bray Wyatt now has the WWE Champion where he wants him. No, big boot from the champ. Notice. Oh, wait a minute. Bray Wyatt looks like a T-bone suplex. T-bone into the pin. One, two, and no. I think Finn Balor was absolutely exhausted. Both of these guys are exhausted. And I think Bray Wyatt knows that. I think he knows he has this in the bag. And a win over the WWE Champion. He could be all of this. The Uranagi! The Uranagi from Bray Wyatt is now the WWE Champion, showing the heart. He's never out of this match. Never out of any match, to be honest. And now Bray going to go for a suplex and then throws him into the corner. Now Bray is going to wait for him to get up. He's going to call. He's going to call for his sister. He has him caught. He kisses him. The kiss of Sister Abigail. And that is going to be it. Wait a minute. Okay. One, two, and three. No! The WWE Champion showing the heart of a champion. But nevertheless, Bray Wyatt, good luck for another one. And now Bray Wyatt just keeps attacking the WWE Champion. Seth Rollins and Finn Balor have made it to the apron as Finn Balor now gets tagged in. Finn Balor not going to go after Bray Wyatt. This is time for revenge. This is time to make a statement against Bray Wyatt. And now takes Bray Wyatt out. Gonna go look for... Oh! Look at that drop kick. Sends him right into the ringside area. Finn Balor. Not gonna wait for him to get up. But Daniel Bryan now gonna kick at him while he's down. And, you know... If, I haven't touched on this at all, but... You gotta think of the chemistry between... Finn Balor and Daniel Bryan. If you think about it, Daniel Bryan has to be a little worried. Finn Balor could actually cash in his money in the bank right now. I mean, after this match, of course, but tonight. And become the WWE Champion, or at least try to. So I didn't even touch on that type of situation there. But it seems Finn Balor's actually maybe even forgotten that he's had the money in the bank. And you know, he's going after Bray Wyatt here. Nevertheless, he's going to... All of this. We all know what's coming now. Finn Balor measuring him up for the shotgun dropkick. And now... Oh, what the hell was that? Now going to go for a pin. One, two, three. That's it? Bray Wyatt couldn't answer that three count. And that's it? The six-man, the three-man team... of Finn Balor, Seth Rollins, and the WWE Champion get it done here tonight. Well, guys, that'll be it for me for SmackDown. I'll see you at WWE Battleground. Take care, my fellow assassins. And, wow, I did not expect that.